marks an obvious support in the Philippines. Thank you very much, Mr. President, for your remarks. Thank you very much, Mr. President, for your remarks and obvious support of investment in the Philippines. In your speech, you discussed the fact that the Philippines is now allowing full foreign direct ownership in companies providing public infrastructure. How important is foreign direct investment into achieving those economic plans of yours, Mr. President?
Certainly, as we attempt to transform the economy, and I use the word transform because it is my belief that the way to bring our economies back to the activity, the level of activity that we enjoyed before the pandemic, we have to understand that the global economy has changed. And we have to position ourselves, certainly, to be able to take advantage of those changes, to have a head start in the new economy that we are still, as of now, starting to form globally. And a large part of that will be foreign investment in the Philippines. And when I speak of foreign investment, I speak especially of capital-intensive investment. Because although we have our GDP, if we look at our GDP figures, a great deal of the contribution to GDP has been in our service sector. And therefore, we think that it is manufacturing, the area of manufacturing, where we can still do a better job. And this is one way, the foreign direct investment, capital-intensive investment, is also something that we are going to actually to need for us to be able to achieve the targets that we have set for our economy, have set for our country. And it is going to be key. As we are trying to define or determine the mix between loans and capital-intensive investment. So the part that capital-intensive investments plays is going to be a very important aspect of this transformation of our economy that I speak of. So that is a large part of what we are doing here. And that is why when I came here to New York, ostensibly, first of all, because we are attending the, I will be speaking before the UN General Assembly tomorrow, but I also brought the whole economic team of the government, of the cabinet, with us. And again, the private sector business leaders also are here with us, precisely to show and explain once to our prospective investors where the Philippines is headed, what changes we have made so that investment will be more profitable and more attractive for foreign investors, especially coming from the United States. So it plays a central role in all that we are planning to do for our economy. It is, once again, something that we recognize in government we have a part to play in. We have to fundamentally restructure the bureaucracy, the government. We listen to the chambers of commerce that tell us what are the obstacles that they find that in their way, such as the ease of doing business, the prices of energy, all of these and these other legislative guarantees that investors are looking for. And I believe we are headed in the right direction. And I believe that if we continue down this road and we are able to attract investors to this new investing climate that we are starting to create in the Philippines, then I believe that with the role that foreign direct investment will play, I think we could succeed. But that just illustrates how important we consider that investment to the transformation of our economy.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. President.